Well, in just a few days, Delaware's Republican senatorial nominee Christine O'Donnell has gone from virtual unknown to campaign sensation to Sarah Palin-style political celebrity. She spoke this afternoon to the Values Voters Summit in Washington.
Will they attack us? Yes. Will they smear our backgrounds and distort our records? Undoubtedly. Will they lie about us, harass our families, name call, and try to intimidate us? They will. There's nothing safe about it. But is it worth it? Yes. Well, let me ask you. Is freedom worth it? Yes. Is America worth it? Yes. Are those unalienable rights worth a little alienation from the Beltway popular crowd? Yes. I say yes, yes, a thousand times yes.
Well, she's talking about smears and distortions, and certainly a lot of liberals in the media are going after her, making fun of her, attacking her. All we care about, though, tonight are facts. There's nothing partisan about it. We've done a lot of segments on allegations against Democrats, Charlie Rangel, recently about Eddie Bernice Johnson, and other Republicans as well. So with that said, we learned today that a nonpartisan group, the Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, are calling for the U.S. Attorney in Delaware to launch a criminal investigation into Ms. O'Donnell's finances. I want to bring in Melanie Sloan, who's the group's executive director. So why are you calling for a criminal investigation?
We went through Ms. O'Donnell's campaign finance records, and we've talked to one of her former campaign aides, someone you, in fact, had on last night, David Keegan. And it turns out Ms. O'Donnell has treated her campaign funds like they're her very own personal piggy bank. She has used that money to pay things like her rent, for gas, meals, and even a bowling outing. And that's just flat out illegal.
But, I mean, we had the checks on the program last night, and it's, you know, a couple hundred dollars here, a couple hundred dollars there. Does it really amount to much of anything?
Well, by our count, it amounts to well over $20,000 in 2009 and 2010, and that's just the funds that we can look at as clearly illegal. The fact is, the Federal Election Commission needs to do an audit to find out all of the expenses that Ms. O'Donnell has claimed as campaign-related, because it may well be that most of them aren't. For example, in 2009, Ms. O'Donnell wasn't a candidate for anything, yet she had numerous campaign expenses, things like travel and gas, and yet she had no actual campaign.
We called, obviously, her spokesperson for comment. We didn't get a response back from them. We haven't heard back from them yet. Obviously, we still continue to welcome that. What is the likelihood of, I mean, what happened? You've called for an investigation. What does that actually mean? What is the next step? And how long, if the U.S. attorney decided to do this, how long would something like that take?
Well, it's hard to say. We're going to be sending him a letter on Monday, and we're filing a complaint there and with the Federal Election Commission. We're saying that Ms. O'Donnell committed the crime of conversion by abusing her campaign funds for personal use. She made false statements on the form she filed with the Federal Election Commission when she lied about some of her campaign expenditures. And then she likely committed tax evasion by failing to declare the income from the campaign funds as personal income since she used it for personal expenses. So the U.S. attorney should start investigating. The FEC should investigate, but this could all take many months, and it won't be resolved before Ms. O'Donnell faces the voters in November.
And to, you know, those of her supporters who no doubt will say, well, look, this is just a smear. This is just, you know, a liberal group from Washington trying to, you know, tarnish her because she's now, you know, in the running.
Well, Cruz's track record is clear. We're nonpartisan. We were on your show within the past couple of weeks talking about Eddie Bernice Johnson's problems, just for example, and we've certainly been out in front on Charlie Rangel's and Maxine Waters. So we look at both sides.
You actually called for Charlie Rangel to step down.
Yes, we've called on him to resign. We're about right and wrong, and not about black or white, Republican or Democrat, and it is flat out wrong for a candidate for the U.S. Senate to be stealing her campaign funds and using them for personal use. And you don't have to just take Cruz's word for it. You have her former campaign aide, a self-described conservative, who's the one who brought this to our attention, who supplied an affidavit for us talking about, for example, the times in 2009 when she used campaign funds to pay her rent to this campaign aide's nephew, who bought her house in 2008 when it was about to be foreclosed upon.
Even if the U.S. attorney in Delaware, though, believes, you know, there's cause here for an investigation, that's a tough call for them to be investigating somebody. I mean, it looks political no matter how you slice it.
Well, David Weiss, the U.S. attorney for Delaware, was in the U.S. attorney's office during the Bush administration, so he's not, by any stretch of the imagination, an Obama appointee. And whether or not it looks political, it is up to the Department of Justice to keep our elected officials honest, to keep our candidates honest, and this goes to the very heart of our democracy. Everybody has to follow the same rules, Ms. O'Donnell included.
Melanie Sloan, it's a fascinating time we're living in. We'll continue to follow it. Thanks for being on. Appreciate it.
Thanks.